The world of Harry Potter comes to life in Brussels during the summer of 2016. We went to the opening of the exhibition and had a chance to meet James and Oliver Phelps, or Fred and George Weasley, at the press conference.
When we began this process, we were given unlimited access to go into the Leavesden studios while they were shooting and depict hundreds of props and costumes and artifacts from all of the different films, some that weren't even in production yet, to be able to bring them to the exhibition and then take them all over the world.
We thought if we could celebrate the people who made the costumes and made all these terrific props and designed the films, that if we could help put that on a pedestal and celebrate that, that that would be special. It would be unique in and of itself.
Well, as you can imagine, with the success of the films and the books, we knew that it would be fantastic to bring some of these elements out into the public so that the fans could actually see them up close and personal. So I think that was the main idea of having the exhibition.
There's nothing hidden in your head the sorting hat can't see. So try me on, I will tell you where you ought to be. Brave at heart, daring, better be Gryffindor!
James and Oliver Phelps, better known as Fred and George Weasley, are excited to be back in Brussels.
It was really cool when we were told that the exhibition was coming here, because we know how passionate the Belgium fans are, and it was really a good experience when we came here before, so it's great to be back.
They talk about a big confusion.
And about half an hour before the film, before the recording, we still didn't know who was playing who. And so we're like, okay, we need to ask someone, because this could go on for a while, like it could go on for a couple of years, so let's find out. So we asked the head casting director, Janet, who's playing Fred and who's playing George? And she's like, oh, good one, good one. I'm like, no, seriously, we don't know who's playing who. So she's like, oh, okay. So she went around the other side of the table and spoke to Chris Columbus, J.K. Rowling, and David Heyman. And she came back a couple of minutes later and said, I said, James, you're Fred, Oliver, you're George.
We found out their favorite Quidditch position.
Well, I do play a lot of cricket at home, so probably a beater anyway, like the characters. I'm used to a bat. That'd be pretty cool, but I don't know how it would work. Maybe I did actually tell someone once, only joking, but it may have got lost in translation somewhere, that when we filmed the Quidditch in the film, we did it skydiving.
Oh, no. So
that didn't happen, just so that's cleared up.
They choose their favourite memento.
Like every character's one was totally unique to that character. And I always thought at the end of the film, final day film, and they say, thanks, good run, 12 years, whatever, here's your wand. And it was a case of last day, okay, bye then. Right, okay. And then, and then we see it exhibited here, behind glass. I think it's only behind glass while we're here, because then we're trying to get to it.
And it's a magical world for everyone.
Yeah, I think anybody who is into the creative process, there is so much detail that went into the making of these films and all of these props and costumes that I think anybody would truly enjoy the exhibition.
Another thing you'll learn on this exhibition is that not everything is real.